Hi, today I am going to start a new chapter, inverters. Very important chapter, lots of applications of inverters you can see. For household applications, you can see your inverter that converts DC input to AC output. There are various sources like battery, energy obtained from solar cells, fuel cells, or wherever DC supply you have, you want AC supply, you have to use inverters. So many applications of inverters you will see. So let's start. The objective of this chapter is to learn the switching techniques of DC to AC converters. How DC is converted to AC. To study the operation of single phase and three phase inverters. These are two most popular available inverters. Then to understand the performance parameters of different inverters. Here the performance parameters means harmonics of the AC output voltage, the magnitude of fundamental component across the AC output voltage, quality of the current waveform, RMS output voltage, etc. We will understand. To learn different types of pulse width modulation. As we have seen in DC choppers, by changing the on period of the switches, we can control the output voltage. Likewise, here also, by changing the on period of switches, we can control the AC output voltage. At the same time, we can reduce the harmonic content across the output voltage. That we will see. It converts DC input voltage to AC output voltage of desired magnitude and frequency. In our country, we are using 50 Hz AC supply. For domestic application, 230 volt. For industrial application, 440 volt. But more than that, you can obtain from variable output voltage can be obtained by varying the DC input voltage or switching pulses. The gain of the inverter I will define as AC output voltage divided by the DC source voltage. For low and medium power applications, square wave inverters may be acceptable. Sometimes it has been seen that a square wave inverter can operate for motor load also. But for high power applications, we need purely sinusoidal waveforms, or you can say reduced harmonics sinusoidal waveforms. Due to availability of high speed switches, MOSFET, IGBTs, the harmonic content of the output voltages can be reduced significantly by different PWM techniques. Here we will see single pulse width modulation, multiple pulse width modulation. That these are the basics of sinusoidal pulse width modulation, then modified sinusoidal pulse width modulation, and other modulation techniques, such as vector based. These are used in industrial applications, variable AC drives, induction heating, uninterrupted power supplies, and many applications you will see. So let's start with inverters. Basically, based on the output voltage, two types of inverters are popular: single phase and three phase inverters. Then based on the output voltage and current quality, three types of converters are there: voltage source, current source, and resonant pulse inverter. Voltage source inverters are more popular in domestic applications. Current source inverters are used for drive applications. Resonant pulse inverters are very efficient inverters. In the circuit diagram, you can see there are four switches, 1, 2, 3, 4, and a DC voltage is connected. Here two types of switches are shown. In one switch, you can see here IGBT is connected in parallel with a diode. This is used in case of voltage source inverter, because in voltage source inverter the output voltage waveform is independent of load impedance, or so to allow free flow of current, this anti-parallel diode is connected. And in case of current source inverter, we want current should be independent of load impedance, so our diode is connected in series with the IGBT. Basic working principle, you can see from here that when the switch number 1 and 2 is on, this current will flow in this direction. And when 3 and 4 is on, then the direction of current will be like this. So when 1, 2 is on, at that time 3, 4 will be off. And when 3, 4 is on, then 1, 2 will be off. So in both direction, current you can get. That means across the load, you can get positive as well as negative voltage as well as current. So DC voltage you are giving, and positive and negative both voltages you are getting. That means DC is converted to AC. We will go in detail about these converters. This is your three phase inverters. Likewise, here two switches are there for voltage source inverter and it is for current source inverter. And one more difference you will see in current source inverter, that with voltage source inductor is connected in series, that I will discuss later on. Here six switches will be there, 1, 3, 5, 4, 6, 2, and these six switches will operate to provide three phase VA, VB and DC output voltage, and these output voltages are 120 degree out of phase. So let's start with single phase half bridge inverter. You can see here in this circuit diagram two voltage sources I have connected, VDC1 and VDC1. Both are of same magnitude and a load is resistive load. Switch 1 and switch 2. Now when the switch 1 is on, at that time switch 2 will be off. So the direction of current will be like this. So in this direction current will be. When switch 2 is off, then direction of current will be opposite to the initial one. Like this it will be. So across the resistance you will get positive voltage as well as negative voltage. Here total input voltage equal to VDC1 plus VDC1, that means twice of VDC1, but the output voltage you will get, that is half of twice of VDC1, that means VDC1. That's why the name is single phase half bridge inverter. Now let's see the operation of this half bridge inverter with the help of these equivalent circuits. So when the switch 1 is on and 2 is off, that means in this loop no current will flow. So when the switch 1 is on, you can see the direction of current is like this, and the polarity across the output is positive negative. When the switch 1 is off and 2 is on, then you can see the direction of current is like this. So like this current will flow. So it is opposite to this one. So these two currents are opposite but of equal magnitude. At the same time, polarity of the output voltage is reverse. Here it was positive negative, here it is opposite to that one. So both positive voltage and negative voltage you are getting across the load. That's why we are saying that this DC voltage is converted to AC. So let's see the waveform of this half bridge inverter. So when the switch number 2 is on, you can see the output voltage is negative. This is your reference line 0, so the output voltage is negative. When the switch 2 is off, at that time switch 1 will come into action. So as soon as 1 is on, you will get this positive output voltage from here to here. So this is your positive output voltage. And again when switch number 2 will be on, then you will get this negative output voltage. So likewise, it will continue, and you can see that it is positive voltage, negative voltage, positive, negative. So is the output voltage you are getting, though it is a square wave. From 0 to pi, output voltage is positive, and it is your half cycle of the output voltage. And from pi to 2 pi, output voltage is negative. So this is your next half cycle of the output voltage. So from 0 to 2 pi, it is your complete cycle of the output voltage, or you can say complete time period. And the frequency of the AC voltage, 1 divided by the total time period. So for one half cycle, it is 1 by t, 0 to t by 2, this V by 2 whole square into dt is equal to V by 2. You can see the waveform, where it is 0 to t by 2, this is V by 2, and t by 2 to t, it is minus V by 2. So only one half cycle we are taking and multiplied by 2, because this will be squared, then same value will get. So Vrms is equal to square root of 2 by t, 0 to t by 2, V square by 4, dt is equal to V by 2. So V by 2 is the RMS value of the output voltage. So from here, we can say that if our input voltage is V by 2, then RMS value is equal to also V by 2. Now let's analyze the output voltage waveform. So Vt is equal to instantaneous output voltage at an instant t, and in Fourier series it can be expressed as equal to a0 plus n is equal to 1 to infinity an cos n omega t plus bn sin n omega t. So a periodic function can be expressed as a summation of DC component plus cosine component plus sine component. Now how much component of this DC cos or sine is there across our output voltage? Let's find. A0, 1 by 2 pi, 0 to 2 pi, Vt d omega t. Here, 0 to pi, let's see the waveform. 0 to pi, V by 2, and pi to 2 pi, it is minus V by 2. So average value is 0. Then An, An is equal to 1 by pi, 0 to 2 pi, Vt cos n omega t d omega t. And this Vt, you just split it 0 to pi and pi to 2 pi, as this cos n omega t term is there. So integration of this will come sin n omega t by n, and sin of any value 0, pi, 2 pi or any odd or even number, you will get 0. So an is also 0. Then bn, bn is equal to 1 by pi, 0 to 2 pi, vt sin on n omega t d omega t. Split this 0 to 2 pi in 0 to pi and pi to 2 pi, and put the value of this vt, as it is instantaneous value at any instant of time. So from 0 to pi, vt is equal to, you can see, from 0 to pi, vt is equal to v by 2. And pi to 2 pi, vt is equal to minus v by 2. So just substitute this value. So here 1 by pi, 0 to pi, v by 2 sin n omega t plus pi to 2 pi minus v by 2 sin n omega t d omega t. Finally, you will get v by 2 n pi minus 2 cos n pi plus 1 plus cos 2 n pi. Now here it is n is equal to 1 to infinity. So just put n is equal to 1, see what will happen. So for n is equal to 1, it is cos pi. So cos pi is minus 1. So this term will become 2, then plus 1. And this 2 pi, cos 2 pi is plus 1. So total it will become 4. So finally you will get 2v by pi. Then put n is equal to 2. So you will see for cos 2 pi, it is 1. So here it minus 2 plus cos of 4 pi, 4 pi is 1, so 1 plus 1 2, and here it is minus 2, so it is 0. So you will observe that for n is equal to 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 or any odd number, you will get the voltage 2V by n pi. And for even number, substituting n is equal to 2, 4, 6, 0 value you will get. So from equation number 3, we can conclude that as the sinusoidal component, already a0 is 0, an is 0, now bn is also 0 for n is equal to 2, 4, 6 or any even number. Our output voltage does not contain any even harmonics, but odd harmonics are present. So we can write Vt is equal to n is equal to 135 to infinity 2v by n pi sine n omega t, where n is equal to 135. Now as n is in the denominator, so as value of n increases, then this value 2v by n pi, it is the peak of the sinusoidal signal. So as the value of n increases, so this magnitude of this sinusoidal component will reduce. So we can say the higher order harmonics are very less, right? Or the contribution of higher order harmonics in our output voltage is less, very less, but lower order harmonics are there. So n is equal to 1 will give you the fundamental component V01, and the RMS value of this V01 and the RMS value of that fundamental component is equal to Vm by root 2. So 2V by pi divided by root 2. This is the fundamental component present across the output voltage, and we want this fundamental component from the square wave, and for that filtering arrangement is to be done or PWM technique is to be developed. So today I have discussed about objective of this chapter, then little bit about working principle of converter, then in detail we have discussed single phase, half bridge, inverter, then we have found out the RMS value of the output voltage, then I have analyzed the complete square wave output voltage using Fourier analysis and concluded that even harmonics are not present in the output voltage, but odd harmonics are present. In later classes, we will discuss in detail about this converter. Thank you.